Lucky Land Casino, asking people, what's the weirdest place you've gotten lucky?
Lucky? In line at the deli, I guess?
Aha, in my dentist's office. More than once, actually.
Do I have to say?
Yes, you do.
In the car, before my kids' PTA meeting.
Really?
Yes.
Excuse me, what's the weirdest place you've gotten lucky?
I never win and tell.
Well, there you have it. You can get lucky anywhere, playing at LuckyLandSlots.com. Play for free right now. Are you feeling lucky? No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
Judy was boring.
Hello.
Then Judy discovered Chumbacasino.com.
It's my little escape.
Now Judy's the life of the party.
Oh, baby, mama's bringing home the bacon.
Whoa, take it easy, Judy. The Chumba life is for everybody. So go to Chumbacasino.com and play over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
This is The Week Ahead from Mark Nolan's podcast, looking at what will be making the news this week in Spain, the UK, Europe, and beyond. Remember to add this podcast to your favorite platform, and you can add us to your Alexa Flash briefing. Full details of how are on the website, marknolanspodcast.com. Here is Mark Nolan with The Week Ahead.
Hello, and well, first of all, I should have explained this to my very capable, shall we say, AI assistant, Lily, because we're not actually doing the week ahead, we're doing the year ahead this week, because whilst we're transitioning from the Christmas and New Year break into the new world of 2024, and whilst allowing everyone to get their 2024 scheduling ducks in a row, we thought I'd look at what we can expect throughout this year might be more appropriate for this first episode, starting with the first half of 2024. You might want to grab a pen, tear down the calendar if you want, and make a note of some of the key dates coming up.
Go and grab a pen and paper in case you need to make notes.
There's still a lot going on this week, such as a tube strike in London, the Commons returning after recess, and the International Court of Justice looking into South Africa's complaint over war crimes and genocide enacted by Israel. On a light note, this week marks the 25th anniversary of The Sopranos TV show airing for the first time, and sports fans have the Australian Open to look forward to. One of the most significant developments of 2024, however, is likely to be controlled by the people as it's election year. In the UK particularly, where, by all current standings, the current run of the Conservatives will come to an end and Labour will regain power. Quite how that will manifest remains to be seen, and it might not happen, as the Tories seem desperate to cling to power by delaying the inevitable as long as possible, but I suppose they are living in hope that they might turn public opinion in their favour in this now relatively short space of time. There might be a taste of things to come in May, if the general election hasn't been called by then, as the UK will have the chance to show its opinion in the local elections on May the 2nd, which also include the mayoral election in London. The Commons does, of course, return from recess on Monday of this week, with the Rwanda bill topping the headline grabbers. In Northern Ireland, January the 18th is a key date, as that's the deadline for the agreement to be reached to restore the executive government, or elections will be on the cards there. Of course, it's not just the UK where elections are being held. Another vote of significance will be held in the European elections. Many people in the UK have been led to believe that Europe was run by unelected bureaucrats, neglecting the fact that one of the loudest voices in that lie, Nigel Farage, was in fact elected into a position in Europe, as in fact the people of Europe do indeed vote for the representatives. And again, ironically, one of the people championing the unelected bureaucrat's message was himself an unelected bureaucrat, Dominic Cummings. Although, of course, in European elections, the UK are now excluded. The US and Europe mark the 80th anniversary of D-Day landings on June the 6th, the same day as the elections in European Parliament get underway. We also have the presidential elections in the USA to look forward to this year, and a potential Joe Biden-Donald Trump rematch. There are actually elections in at least 60 countries this year, Bhutan being the first this week. And in Spain, there will also be elections throughout, although only on a relatively localised sense. The Spanish government, regional and local for the most part, is now set for the next few years. Finally, though, the biggest election news of the year might be in March, when Russia has a chance to vote for their leader. We wouldn't suggest rushing to the bookies for odds on Vladimir Putin not winning, however. Presidential elections are also scheduled at the end of March in Ukraine, incidentally. Prior to that, Ukraine will be dominating the news mid-February as NATO defense ministers meet ahead of the opening of the Munich Security Conference on February the 16th, just a week before the second anniversary of Russia's invasion on February the 24th. On May the 9th, Vladimir Putin, whoever wins the Russian elections, we should say, will take to the streets of Moscow in the annual Victory Day celebrations. In the 2024 financial outlook, February will start with either good news or bad news, with the first interest rates decision of the year announced by the Bank of England. February will also be a key month due to the release of GDP figures for the final quarter of 2023, which will confirm whether or not the UK entered recession at the end of the year, after revised figures showed a 0.1 contraction between July and September. May the 9th will be the next key date when the Bank of England makes its latest decision then. In entertainment, the award season continues with the Grammy Awards on February the 4th and the BAFTA Film Awards on February the 18th, with David Tennant now confirmed as the host. And then the Brit Awards on March the 2nd, followed by the Oscars on March the 10th. In other entertainment news, shall we say, Liz Truss's book on saving the West from the global left is released on April the 16th, the same day, ironically, that the IMF publishes its latest World Economic Outlook. In May, celebrities will gather for the Met Gala on May the 6th and Eurovision Grand Final on May the 11th and then the BAFTA TV Awards on May the 12th. And Glastonbury opens on June the 26th and London celebrates London Pride on June the 29th. Sports fans also have a lot to look forward to this year, and apologies for soap fans for the inevitable disruption in advance, as 2024 also sees the Paris Olympics even, and the Paralympic Games, as well as Euro 2024 in Germany, and the T20 World Cup all on the calendar. In America, all eyes will be on the Super Bowl in February, February the 11th to be precise, not only for fans of the sport, but now the famous halftime show and the extortionate amounts businesses pay for advertising slots being revealed. March sees the starts of the F1 season in Bahrain and the final round of the Six Nations tournament on March the 16th. In April, we'll have the County Championship cricket season starting on April the 5th, the Grand National on April the 13th, and the London Marathon on April the 21st to look forward to. And for football fans, the Premier League season comes to a close on May the 19th, followed closely by the FA Cup final on May the 25th. And finally, the Champions League final will be on June the 1st, rounding off the football season. And remember, you can get more about what's going on this week on the Daily Podcast Spain Today, which you can get on the same podcast platforms as this. Just search for Mark Nolan's Podcast on your favourite platform or go to marknolanspodcast.com to listen online.
That was The Week Ahead from Mark Nolan's Podcast. To be the first to find out what will be making the news headlines each week, search and subscribe to Mark Nolan's Podcast on your favourite platform, including iTunes, Amazon, Alexa, and Spotify. From Mark Nolan and me, Lily, we'll see you next time.
At Kroger, shopping with pickup and delivery is the same as shopping in-store. Same low prices, deals, and rewards on the same high-quality items. It's one small click for groceries, one big win for busy families everywhere. Start your cart today at Kroger.com. Kroger, fresh for everyone. Restrictions apply. See site for details.
Save big on your favorites with the Buy 5 or More Save a Dollar Each sale. Simply buy 5 or more participating items and save a dollar each with your card. Kroger, fresh for everyone.
Kroger always gives you savings and rewards on top of our lower-than-low prices. And when you download the Kroger app, you can enjoy over $500 in savings every week with digital coupons. Plus, you can earn fuel points to save up to $1 per gallon at the pump. So it's easy to save big. Kroger, fresh for everyone. Savings may vary by state. Fuel restrictions apply.
We've locked in low prices to help you save big store-wide. Look for the locked-in low prices tags and enjoy extra savings throughout the store. Kroger, fresh for everyone.